Most of what we do in life is unconscious. Whether you are the person that decides that if you're not sure what to do in life, you're just going to do what other people are doing. You know, you get the safe, secure job, you settle down at 30, you live the straight and narrow, you never leave your hometown, or you're somebody who rebels and lives a crazy, unconventional life. But in this video, I thought I would share one thing that I think can maybe help you wake up from the matrix. What's up, guys? Alex Hine. Author of the weird book named Milk the Pigeon. It's not that weird, not that kinky. I think it's pretty helpful at helping you wake up, but you be the judge. Before we jump in to this matrix busting video, check out the link below. It's for a free journaling worksheet. If you want to wake up, start living the life you actually want, download that and fill it out. So look, you guys, I'm rebellious, but not in the way that you think. You know, when typically you think of a kid that's a teenager and they're rebellious, you think about them like going over to the Mr. Jones's house and like egging them, right? Or stealing something from the local candy store, or doing the old, Happy Gilmore, putting some dog poo in a paper bag and lighting it on fire on somebody's porch. That's what you think of as being rebellious most of the time. But the way that I've always been since I was young is more intellectually rebellious. I'm more the person who will incite the rebellion or pay the kid 20 bucks to go poop in the bag and light it and put it on the old fogey's porch around the corner, all right? So that's my version of rebellion. And the way that came to be was this understanding when I was young that, like Mihaly Csikszentmihalyi said, the founder of this concept, flow, he said that most of us, when we are unsure what to do in our lives, we do either one of two things. Most of us conform, i.e. we do what we see other people doing, either consciously or not consciously, subconsciously, and the other group of people rebels. But very few people do what is in between. The conscious path, which is really thinking about what you actually want to do and being deliberate about how you want to live. Now, why is this so important? Because I think what we are talking about here, when the movie The Matrix came out and when Neo was offered that pill, that was really this idea of continue sleepwalking through life or wake up. And you might not like what you see if you wake up, because being an unconscious automaton might be a more content life than actually waking up and seeing reality for how it really is. You know, there are all kinds of cliches about really intelligent people, the most intelligent people being both the most antisocial and the most unhappy. You know, Nikola Tesla has this great quote that antisocial behavior is a trait of intelligence in a conformist society, that to be antisocial is actually quite a wise or quite an evolved thing to do and to be. And obviously, he was tooting his own horn. But the point being is that the matrix is when we are sleepwalking through life. The matrix is when we don't know the game being played around us in life, where we are deciding unconsciously, either through conformity or unconsciously through rebellion, when neither of those are maybe aligned with our goals. Or maybe one of those is aligned with our goals, in which case that is what we should be doing. You know, if you want to be the doctor, conforming is a good thing because it's an existing job and maybe it has prestige in your country. Maybe it makes you money in your country. But if you decide that what you want to do is you want to be a poet and you want to travel around Southeast Asia and you're going to lose the respect of your friends and your family, then maybe that's what you still should be doing. You know, this is the conscious path. This is waking up from the matrix. But I think the quintessential aspect of waking up from the matrix is just one thing. Deciding deliberately how you want to be and how you want to react to something. This year with COVID has been the perfect case study of looking at how human psychology works. Because the people I know that were more on the anxious and hypochondria side before COVID now became basket cases. So it only exacerbated, you know, if the thread, the tendency is towards overreaction, they just went off the deep end. And the friends that were like, screw the government, it's all a conspiracy, they went off the deep end. And the friends of mine that were pretty level-headed and looking at the research, made level-headed decisions, made the best decision they thought was correct, and then they kept living that way. And so many of us, though, live this life of overreaction or underreaction, rather than thinking, how do I really want to be? What kind of person do I want to become? And therefore, what actions should I be taking that are congruent with the kind of person I want to become? So I think what unifies all of this, what unifies waking up from the matrix is, number one, deciding that you're going to consciously decide who you want to be. You know, you see these unconscious kind of reactions where you have, in the male dating space, they talk about red pill, right? They talk about being woken up to this game around dating women where they just want to date the richest guy, the most fun guy, the woman with the most status and prestige. And sure, those underlying currents are there, just like most men want to date the most physically beautiful girl. These are biological things that it's hard to fight. But the point being that that is still an unconscious reaction, because a lot of these men that are in this kind of community are often these kind of butthurt, for lack of a better word, butthurt men that are sore and they're whining. And rather than thinking, you know what, I'm going to channel my feelings of rejection by women into becoming the best version of myself, rather than doing that, they often channel it into this deep kind of melancholy and this resentment and this apathy. Apathy would be a good thing, actually. Resentment can even trigger shootings or violence towards women and other people. So this is still an unconscious path. And what I'm trying to encourage people here to do the most is to think about your life. Just think. Earl Nightingale, great personal development speaker, said, most men would rather resort to crime than even think about their life. Because crime is easier than sitting down and coming up with a strategy to live a better life. So I think when people make these references to waking up from the matrix, what we really have to pay attention to is thinking, what kind of person do I actually want to become? Even if it's hard, even if it's easy, who do I actually want to become? And regardless of whether or not this is popular in my society at this moment in time, still doing it. And again, not worrying about if you are loved or hated. That is that monk's quality of equanimity, of being okay if they love you. You know, if you get notoriety for your work and what you do, great. Treat it like an annoying little mosquito. And if you are hated for some reason on the other side of that, because this exact moment in time or your society or your gender or your career is controversial somehow or culturally at odds, then you're at peace with that too. And that makes you a strong leader, and that makes you an exceptional human being. So in terms of waking up from the matrix, my two cents is, don't react to any one way, but decide and then lead the field, because that will make you someone who is breathing rare air. Now, Skillshare currently has an awesome deal going on through September. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare, so you guys can start exploring your creativity today. Now, for example, one of the courses that I actually joined was called DSLR Filmmaking for Beginners, and that really helped me understand more about how to produce more professional YouTube videos, the lighting, the aperture, the lens, and so on. So don't forget to check out the link right below this video for that special for you guys. Skillshare is a company I actually love and I actually use, so check it out. Again, don't forget, get the free download below on that journaling worksheet if you want to wake up from this BS. And besides that, I'll catch you in these two related videos over here.